everyone, happy Sunday. I hope you're having a beautiful day. I'm quickly going to share 50 random facts about me, and I need you to practice the same exercise, and I need you to sit down with yourself and see, do you know yourself enough to write down 50 random facts about you? Beginning with number one, I have actually written it all down because I know I digress. So this is just going to assist me. I am a master of my emotions. You can't make me feel something that I am not open to receive or feel. I am very tall, but sometimes I feel like I am too short. I am an extremist, all in it to win it, or I would not show up. I am dead, I don't bother. I am a self-taught person. So when it comes to nutrition, when it comes to health, when it comes to makeup, when it comes to taking care, when it comes to cooking, anything and everything that I know, I have learned it by myself. I am a brilliant cook. I can make anything healthy, cook it and eat it. And I really believe if people could eat what I cook, everyone would love healthy food. I have 7 tattoos on my body. So this is one, this says Ma. I got it done for my mom's birthday, I think 2, 3, 4 years ago. This was the first post on my Instagram, I believe. There's another one here. It's, I don't know if you can see it, but it's, it symbolizes fire. So I have like all the elements that we are made up of on my body. And then I have one, this says Mastermind. So 7 tattoos. I absolutely hate wearing jeans. I love pants. I can't look at people who are wearing jeans. It just makes me so uncomfortable. I get body massage every week. I love back rubs and someone scratching my head and putting me to sleep. So it's like, you know, when people do this massage slightly, I'm like, oh my God, it's so orgasmic. I like to eat desserts for breakfast, or I like to eat dessert before my meals and not after my meals. I was addicted to peanut butter now. I was addicted to peanut butter, but now I don't even remember how it tastes. So very, very physically, emotionally, mentally addicted to peanut butter, absolutely. And I think I can still fall back into that rut if I don't control myself. I can get ready, look sleek in less than 5 minutes. Very, very true. I don't invest any time in my hair and my face, nothing. So I'm sitting here in front of you. I think this is less than 2 minutes. Just kajal, lipstick, groom your eyebrows, your hair, and that's it. There's nothing on face. I have been cooking for myself for years now. So I make all of my meals. I don't have any assistants. Mom does not do it for me. We don't have a cook. I cook every meal. And that's, I think, how I have learned to, you know, just master the art of healthy cooking. I have never commented hate towards anyone or disliked someone's video or post ever in my life, except once. I never feel hurt towards anyone hate against me anymore. That's very true. I used to be very, very bothered by looking at hate comments and hate messages, but I don't care. I don't consider myself a writer. Quora is a luck by chance of my life. I am not a writer, okay? Modeling was never planned. It happened. I didn't learn how to be a model. I knew how to be a model. Nutrition also happened to me. It came to me. It makes every hair on my body stand straight and applaud this miraculous body that we live in. I believe in a non-physical world. I believe in things that we can't see with the 5 senses. I believe in a world that exists beyond what we see here. I believe I am the creator, I am the universe, and I am powerful. I absolutely believe we are all the creators when it comes to our own life. I believe the universe and God and all of the source energy, it sits inside of us and it's not outside, it's inside. I can pick energy on phone by reading a comment, by looking at you. My body picks up positive and negative energy like this. And when something is negative, I will, like, you will not see me there. You will not see me. That's how quickly my body responds now. Beetroot is the only vegetable I can't eat raw. I don't like bread, pasta, noodles, anything starchy usually. I can't stand that amount of food. Like, I love croissant, I love the way it looks, I love bread, I love sourdough, but I don't like eating it. I like looking at it. I love grocery shopping, absolutely. I love to sit alone in cafes and interpret people's health based on what and how they order to eat. So based on what they are ordering to eat and how they are eating, their speed, their mind, how the body's connecting, I can tell the kind of health they are having or they are going to have by looking at them. My predictions always come true. So if I have a knowing and a belief that something is about to happen, it happens. I have never traveled out of India. I love flights and I wish to sit in a cockpit with pilot once. I love airports. I love people. I love to see emotions. I love to just see, I love airports. I can live. I think I have a great sense of humor. I'm a very, very, very funny person to be around. And if I am comfortable and if I am in my zone, I can be the funniest girl you will meet. I am not a people's pleaser. I will not just say something to please you. I can be brutally honest and sound rude at times, but I am always, always, always practicing honesty. I have been dumped and I have dumped men. 2020 is the first year that I have been single and on my own. I don't remember what relationships and love is like anymore. Very, very true. I have, like, you know, dated continuously for 8 years, two different guys. But this is the first year that I've been on my own. And oh my God, welcome to heaven. I might sound self-obsessed, but I'm very extremely ridiculously self-aware. There is a difference between obsession and being aware. I consider myself aware. So that's, yeah, I don't read anything but nutrition 99.999% of the times. If you see me and if there is, like, you know, AirPods on, or if you see me with a book, it's nutrition. It's not a song usually. I am obsessed with my blanket and comforter. I will not touch it if someone else touched, like, you know, if I see someone else holding my blanket, I would go with, like, I would just throw it away. I would not wash it. I'll just go out and get a new one. Like, I legit do that. I can't share my things. I can buy something and gift it to you. I don't really like sharing food. I am obsessed with pen and stationery and stuff. So it's like, I love diaries. I love pen, everything. I love it. Okay, I'm just trying to find something here. I love huge, clean, sleek coffee mugs. I love coffee and I love matcha. So, you know, a mug like this. So I have this right here. I love, 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 love huge mugs, and I speak with my food. So, you know, like, I love you. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for serving me. Thank you so much for feeding every cell of my body. Thank you for making me love you. Thank you for being here. I love you. I love you. I love you. I love you. That's how I eat and drink food most of the times. I used to be obsessed with cars. Now I hate to drive. I don't like touching steering wheel anymore, and I don't have a license yet. Yeah, I don't own a license. I never panic. Oh, by the way, we are at point number 41, and I really hope you're counting. I never panic. I never, never, never panic. I am the most sane person you will find. I don't argue. I don't yell. I just smile, because you don't see what I see. I am always calm. This is very, very true. I am not a person who's going to panic and be like, oh my God, now what? I just have a knowing and a belief that everything happens for a reason, and it's going to be sorted. It's going to be okay. Don't worry. It also happens with my health and my body, but I'm very sorted on that front. I like to wake up in hotel rooms and empty Airbnb. So I am not exactly a people's person. I just like to be with myself. And again, this is not self-obsession. I just love to see the world with my view, and that's just who I am. My discipline is like a clock. I don't need a clock to tell me my time. My body does it to me. So I know when I'm tired, I know when it is time to eat, and if I can look at the clock, I can tell you what exact time it is and what exactly is my body communicating. That's how much I am in touch with myself. I am a very passionate person when it comes to learning about human consciousness. I look at hormones and chemicals when someone is speaking. So this is something that I really, like, ridiculously practice. I will just look at people and I'll be like, oh, okay, this is secretion of that hormone. Okay, that hormone is secreting. Oh, okay, that is why they are feeling that way. Oh, they ate that. That is why they are emotionally behaving like that. Oh, which phase of, you know, menstruation they are in. So I really look at people hormonally and chemically more than just humans. I don't like dinner. I don't like eating dinner. I don't like all-nighters. I don't like movie nights. I don't like talking at night. I love sunset, but that's about it. That's the end of my day. Speak to you tomorrow. I am a morning person, absolutely. So I can wake up at 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Usually it is 3:30 to 4. And I hate working out in the morning. I absolutely have to pick myself, push myself, go to the gym and exercise. but I always do the hardest task of the day first thing in the morning. So if I know I will not work out all throughout the day, I am going to get my ass to the gym and I'm going to work out. And I am slowly transitioning to a phase where I can be a better person, but this is where we stand now. I can eat any amount of laddu non-stop. I have, and that's why I don't keep it around me. Like, you give me a laddu, I will forgive you for anything. Like, you know, besan laddu, any laddu, besan laddu, sattu laddu, peanut butter laddu, dry fruit laddu, seed laddu, I can just eat laddus, okay? And point number 49, I am a powerful meditator. I can live through anything, I can be anywhere, and using my mind, I just know how to meditate, I just know how to be here. So I can literally, in the middle of the video, just close my eyes and I would forget everything. Everything ceases to exist the minute my eyes are shut and I just go into some another world, and I hope everyone feels this way. Point number 50, 2020 has been the best year for me, physically, spiritually, financially, socially, mentally, growth-wise, YouTube, Quora, social media, client success, relationship with my parents, whatnot. It's bang on. It's the best year of my life. This lockdown has been a blessing, and I really want all of the positivity and energy and blessings that I have to reach out to every person who desires it. And that is one prayer that I send out to universe every single day. And just a bonus point here, I am as happy as I look here. So I see a lot of comments where people are like, oh, she's faking. Oh, how can someone be so happy? But this is who I am. This is how it is.